time with mom, story time with dad. This is my favorite story time. Under the bed in my secret fort, and I'm gonna read Where the Wild Things Are by Maurice Sendak. The night Max wore his wolf suit and made mischief of one kind. Wow, he's got a wolf suit pajamas? Yeah, that's so cool. I want to wear one of those. So he was making a string and put his bed curtains up and made a little secret fort. He made all kind of mischief running around the house in his wolf suit with his fork and chased his dog. His mother called him Wild Thing, and Max said, I'll eat you up, Mommy. So he went to bed without eating anything. How about that, Mom said. Wow, she didn't really like me chasing the dog with a fork around the house. Now I'm in bed stuffed with no supper. So that night in Max's room, a forest grew in his room? Yeah, tall trees and vines. And it kept growing and growing. So it grew until the ceiling hung with vines and the walls became the world all around. It was a secret forest adventure, and Max in his wolf suit enjoyed every minute. And an ocean and a private boat were there. So Max climbed in the boat and sailed off through the day and night, and in and out of weeks and almost over a year to Where the Wild Things Are. Oh my gosh, he sailed until where he found wild things, monsters in the sea. Roar! Look at those creatures. And when he came to the place where the wild things are, they roared their terrible roars and gnashed their terrible teeth and rolled their terrible eyes and showed their terrible claws. Oh gosh! I'm gonna get you, Max. No, you're not, because I have a sword. And Max said, be still, and tamed them with a magic trick of staring into their yellow eyes without blinking once, and they were frightful and called them the most wild thing of all. Aha, I can stare into your big, beasty yellow eyes and tame you. You're tame, my wild monster. Be still. And they made him king of the wild things. I am king. And now, cried Max, let the wild rumpus start. Let the partying begin. Yes, sir, your highness, your royal king of the wild things. So they danced and pranced and they sang and danced and they pranced and danced and they sang and danced and they danced and pranced and they hung on the vines, climbed in the trees, and they had a good time because monsters we are and feasting we are. The dump, 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 you're the king of the wild things, king of the wild things. We have a blast. Now stop, Max said, and sent the wild things off to bed without their supper. And Max, the king of all things, was lonely and wanted to be where someone loved him best of all. Then all around and far away across the world, he smelled good things to eat. So he gave up being king where the wild things were. All right, wild things, I'm kind of sad without my family and my home. Being king is fun for the day and at night, but during the day, I want to be home with my family. The wild things cried, oh, please don't go. We'll eat you up. We love you so. And Max said, no, no. The wild things roared their terrible roars and gnashed their terrible teeth and rolled their terrible eyes and showed their terrible claws. But Max stepped into his private boat and waved goodbye. We're going to eat you, Max. We love you. We want you to stay where the wild things are. See you later. I'm in my boat. Ha ha. I'm on the boat. And sailed back over a year and in and out of weeks and through a day. He's making it back on the water to his room and into the night of his very own room where he found his supper waiting for him. Oh, his mom and dad and family loves him so. In his wild suit pajama costume. So he hung up his little wild suit werewolf costume and he went into his covers and went good night. Sir Herbert Sneaky Story Time, read by Lady Twizzleton. Check out Jack the Bear and Golden Hair by Sir Herbert Sneakies at Amazon. Or if you like monsters, enjoy Bloober Goober, The Monster in My Closet in Amazon by Sir Herbert Sneakies.